Good morning students, this is 12th class biology, chapter 7 evolution, and today we will discuss the homework solutions of lecture number 6. Question number 4 of NCERT was given as homework, and the question is trace the various components of human evolution. And here these are different stages of human evolution and the different features of these different stages have been compared here. Okay. So first of all, Dryopithecus africans, this was the first stage of human evolution, and here the size of brain is not mentioned. Okay, it is not confirmed from the fossils that what was the size of brain of these Dryopithecus. So data is not found here for the size of brain. Then body posture, if we talk about, then equal sized arms and legs were present in Dryopithecus. They ate leaves and tender fruits. Tender fruits means the fruits which are not hard, okay, fleshy and soft fruits they ate. Then other features are quadrupedalism, means they used to walk on four limbs. They used to walk like gorillas on four limbs, and they had large sized canines. So this feature you can tell about their skeletal structure also, that they had large canines. The next stage was Ramapithecus, and in Ramapithecus also size of brain is not confirmed, and body posture was semi erect. Okay, they had semi erect posture. They also used to bend like the gorillas and used to walk like that. And their food preference was they used to eat nuts and seeds. Then next is Australopithecus africanus, and the size of brain of Australopithecus was 450 cm³. Okay, and their body posture was completely erect, and their height was around 1.5 m. So they were around 1.5 m tall. Food preference was fruits, so they used to eat fruits, so they were herbivores. Other features are inhabited trees, means they used to live on the trees, and used stone weapons for hunting. Then incisor and canines are smaller than others, than Ramapithecus and Dryopithecus, so their incisors and canines are smaller. After the Australopithecus, next stage was Homo habilis, and these Homo habilis were having the brain of size 735 cm³. Body posture was completely erect, and the height was around 1.5 m. So they were 1.5 m tall. Food preferences, they were carnivorous. Okay, they used to eat meat. Other features are like small canines. And they were first to make the tools with the help of stones. The next stage is Homo erectus after the Homo habilis, and brain size of Homo erectus is 800 cm³ to 1100 cm³, right? Their body posture is completely erect, and their height is around 1.5 m to 1.8 m tall. So you can say height is increasing. Then food preferences, omnivorous, means they used to eat fruits, plant products as well as meat. So they were omnivorous. Other features are for hunting used bone and stone tools. Okay, so they used stone weapons made by stone and bones for the hunting. After that, the next stage was Homo Neanderthals, and Homo Neanderthals were having the brain size 1300 cm³ to 1600 cm³. Their body posture was completely erect, and height was around 1.5 m to 1.66 m. Okay, there was no much increase in height from the Homo erectus to the Homo Neanderthals. Then food preference, they were omnivorous, means used to eat plant products as well as other meat, okay, and other animals, you can say Other features are inhabited caves. Okay, they used to live in caves and buried their deads. Okay, first of all, Homo Neanderthal started burying their deads, and also they hid their bodies for the protection. After that, Homo sapiens. So Homo sapiens is the latest stage of the human evolution, and the brain size is 1650 cm³, and body posture is completely erect. Height is around 1.8 meter, and these are also omnivorous, modern men you can say, and possessed a strong jaw with teeth closely placed. Right, inhabited caves. In the starting, you can say they started inhabiting the caves and made carvings, means the cave arts and the paintings in the cave. So all the cave art come under these paintings and carvings. Developed a culture and were referred to as the first modern man. Okay, so Homo sapiens were the first modern man, and finally these with the time, these Homo sapiens formed the modern man, that is called Homo sapiens sapiens. After that, question number 5 of NCERT is, apart from human, there are many other animals that possess self-consciousness. So the question was, are there any other animals which possess self-consciousness? So yes, there are many other animals which that possess self-consciousness, and one such example is dolphin. Okay, they are believed to have a high level of intelligence. So dolphins also have a high level of intelligence like human being. Also, they have a sense of self and can identify oneself amongst the others. So this is called self-consciousness. Okay, their consciousness is different from the self-consciousness. In consciousness, you only respond to the external stimuli, you only respond to the environment. But in self-consciousness, an organism knows about itself, knows about its identity among the others. Okay, so dolphins have that ability, means the self-consciousness. And there are some other animals also that exhibit self-consciousness, and these are parrot, crow, gorilla, chimpanzee. So these are the animals which have the self-consciousness like human being. Next, NCERT question number 9 is that is human evolution can be referred as adaptive radiation? So answer is no. Human evolution cannot be referred as adaptive radiation, as the adaptive radiation is an evolutionary process which gives rise to new species from a single common ancestor. Right, in adaptive radiation what happens? Many species originate from a common ancestor. But in case of human evolution, although we share a common ancestor, okay, although the ancestor is same like that of adaptive radiation, but the evolution of human does not include diversification and radiating into different species. So you can see, in case of human evolution, no different species have been formed and there is no diversification. A single species has been formed, a gradual type of evolution has taken place. Okay, and only one species, that is called Homo sapiens, has been formed. Okay, so there is no diversification of species. That's why human evolution cannot be referred as adaptive radiation. For today, your homework is to do the assignment of this chapter, which has been uploaded on edgog.com. Tomorrow, I will upload the solutions for that assignment, and after that, there will be test of this chapter.